This person whom we used to work with, and one day he got born again. Baada ya kuokoka, this person, one day when he was cooking in his house, stove ikalipuka na akachomeka part of his body, mkono. Then akasema, kwani sasa nikiokoka ndio vitu zinakuwa mbaya? Then after some time mkewe akawa mgonjwa. Baada ya mkewe kuwa mgonjwa, mkewe kuna wakati sijui alikuwa anaguza stove, sijui akifanya nini tena hiyo stove. Tena huyu mzee akienda kusaidia bibi, tena mafuta ikamwagikia mpaka chomeke mkono mwingine. It's a very real story. Then this guy started asking. Sometimes he would come to me and ask me, is this how salvation is? That now that I'm saved, ndio hasa maneno mabaya yananifanyikia? Akaniambia ni sahihi na Biblia. I took one of my Bibles, full Bible, old na new, kampatia. Na pia ndugu mwingine pia akampatia ingine. So akawa na Bible mbili mara moja kwa siku moja. Akampatia. This person mara nyingi alikuwa ana shughuli ya kuchukua watu kazini wakiingia, watu wa mkono, casual laborers wakiingia. Na mara kwa mara alikuwa anabaki na change wakati wa kuwalipa. Anabaki na sehemu ya fedha. So he had a tendency of eating people's money before he was saved. So when salvation came, I tried explaining to him that God was trying to open your eyes in the things that we do when we are not saved. There comes a time when you can't just move from salvation to glory. There must be a way the Lord must purge you so that aku single out ndipoza hasa akurembeshe vile yeye anataka. You see, there is no shortcut in life. When in the past ulikuwa unafanya mbaya, then unaokoka tu hivi tu na unania mazuri, the Lord must deliver you. Deliverance lazima ifanyike, ambapo hiyo deliverance itaonekana kama Mungu anakumaliza. There's a story in Luke chapter 19, verse 1, the story of Zacchaeus, Zakayo. Zakayo wakati alipanda mkuyu ili aone Yesu, kwanza ilibidi wakati alijisalimisha kumuona Yesu, Yesu akamwambia hivi, leo ndakuwa nyumbani kwako. In fact, alisema atarudisha fourfold, mara nne kwa wale alikuwa anachukua kwao. So it literally means that tunaweza kuona kama Mungu wetu hayuko sometimes when things go bad. But it is also good to reflect into your past. Hapo nyuma ulikuwa unaishi namna gani? Hauko unamtukuza Mungu? Then wakati wa salvation ilikuja ikaingia, ukapata marafiki wazuri, wageni wapya, kisha wakaingia kwa maisha yako, and then ukaanza kunia mazuri. Lakini wakati ndio unania ya mazuri, unania mazuri, lakini lazima kwanza utoe machafu. It is just like mtu aende a rob a bank, you rob a bank, you get money, then you get saved when you have the money. That money is not clean. Even if you happen to do good with it, that good will not be counted as good. Until God comes in and empties you of all the filth. So when that man was being burnt and being burnt, and all the calamities hit him, he used to cry a lot. And I used to tell him, just cry to God. He knows why. He knows why these things are happening. Nothing happens by accident. Yeah, nothing happens by accident. You see, when we indulge in evil, we do that evil like Satan himself. Then when we come to God, we want just things to happen like God wants them, immediately. We may be wrong. We may be wrong. I look at the life of David. There was a time he sinned with a certain woman, and then they got a child, and David really cried for that child to be alive. But God decided that that child must be dead. That child died. David cried. David cried. You can imagine how David cried. David cried about that thing. David akasema, hey, Mungu wangu. Naacha, huyo mtoto hana hatia. Nani alisema mtoto amezaliwa hana hatia? Anakuwa na hatia mingi. Mtoto aliyezaliwa mchanga, kuna hatia sana, kama hujajua. Kuna hatia mingi. Hiyo ni fundisho ingine. Siendi huko. So I want to tell us, this man eventually, he didn't rise in the ranks of leadership in his church, the church that he was going to. But there was calamity after calamity. Until one day, there was a crusade, and he gave a testimony. It was a very touchy testimony. In that crusade, that workmate of mine, he gave up. And he said about his past. He was very sincere with his past. He said every filthy thing that he used to do. He said that crusade. Then wakati akimalizia, akakuja akasema, then God had mercy on me and saved me. When he was giving that testimony, people wailed and wept in that crusade, and people got saved. I want to tell you today, what are the things that you have passed through that you have failed to talk about? Let alone talking about it to people, but even talking about it to God. You look at your past, and you unafunikia, unasema, hiyo ilishapita. Yet, in this life that we lead, the things that pull us down are the things that we did in yesteryears, the things that we did of old, the things that we did long time, they still pull us back. Why? Because they were never confessed. Yeah, the Bible says somewhere in Acts chapter 3, there's an act. Kiswahili naweza kuisema vizuri, lakini kwa Kiingereza nafikiri nitapata. Acts chapter 3, the Bible says somewhere in verse 19, just one verse, a short verse, it says, repent therefore and be converted, that your sins may be blotted out. These are steps. When we get saved, we must repent. That is a step. To repent is to say that sin as it is, to say it to the Lord. Mm-hmm. Then when you have said it to the Lord, then you shall be converted. Conversion comes. Then the third step, your sins are blotted out.
In the church that I got salvation, walikuwa na kipindi kinaitwa utatubishwa, utawekwa kwa kutubu, sema maneno yale ulifanya. And it looked like they were playing. In fact, they were very serious. And when you were saying those things, you were told, do not be happy about those things because they were bad things. Cry to the Lord to forgive you for those things. So you could say every stupid thing you did in the past, you could say them. We told them to people who would keep those secrets and never say them elsewhere. Yes? So that times of refreshing may come from the presence of the Lord. So I'll read again. Repent therefore and be converted, that your sins may be blotted out, so that times of refreshing may come from the presence of the Lord. Times of refreshment may not come because some of us never ani hawakuungama. Hii inaitwa kuungama. Kiswahili nasema kuungama. Tubu alafu ubadilike, dhambi zako zifutwe, uungame, kisha ije siku za furaha sasa. So when that man was undergoing these things, because there was no teacher nearby, he would complain. When he reached me, I would tell him, just pray to God. Tell God all those things that you have been doing. Tell them, tell God you are sorry. Just tell him. Tell him in your own words you are sorry. And every day he would come to me and tell me, it felt very refreshing when I was praying. Then he would tell me that he would hear some strong conviction ya kwamba aseme hizo vitu zote na nazisema mbele za Bwana kitubu. Allow me to say, when God convicts you under the presence, under his presence, it becomes very easy for you to remember the things that were there in the past, and then mwambia tubu hii, unatubu hiyo. Tubu hii, unatubu hiyo. Tubu katika kutubu hizo nyingi hizo na kuungama na kuzisema, they go. When we don't talk about them, they put guilt in us. Unakuwa tunasema hii niliwahi fanya. Hii niliwahi fanya. It lingers in the mind. Yaani inakaa kifuani haitoki. Lakini ikisemwa inatoka. James chapter 5. Yakobo 5. Yes. James chapter 5 verse 16 says, confess your trespasses to one another and pray for one another that you may be healed. Your part end you nataka sana. Confess your sins, your trespasses. Hapa inasema trespasses. Confess your trespasses to one another and pray for one another. Nani ana prayer partner? Kuna mtu ambaye unaweza songa karibu naye umwambie hii kitu nilipitia. Anakuambia Bwana kusamehe. Mungu anisamehe. Only to somebody who can keep a secret, ndio unaweza confess kwa hivi. It brings healing in the body, in the mind, it brings healing. Bwana asifiwe sana. In the Catholic, Wakatoliki, kuna wakati wanaendanga church Saturday, wanasema wanaenda kutubu. Then somebody is hiding on the other side. A wire mesh iko hapo. Utasikia sauti yake lakini umuoni. Kisha unamwambia, nililala na msichana mwingine. Bwana anasema Bwana kusamehe, unasema anisamehe. In fact, niliiba, nilidanganya. And you are very free, you are very true to yourself. Ukisema hivi na akikwambia hivi, Bwana kusamehe. Na wewe unasikia tu kama yeye Bwana amenisamehe. Hiyo ni kitu. Hiyo ni kitu. In fact, that confession is done in the Catholics. Kila every Saturday. I was there. I was a member then. And between 1984 to 1994, wakati niliacha Katoliki, sikuwahi ingia kwa church yoyote. Yeah, between 1984, baka 1994, niliachana na church, kasema, hizi maende ya kutututuku. Then I sat away. Kumbe God was preparing me aniingize kwa Pentecostal church. Bwana asifiwe sana. So I'm here to say, when we confess our trespasses to one another and we pray for one another, healing comes. Healing of the soul. Soul ni nafsi yako. Nafsi yako ndio imejaa tamaa nyingi, imejaa kujificha kwingi, hali nafsi. Nafsi yako hiyo iko na kiu nyingi. Kiu nyingi na katika nafsi. So hiyo nafsi ndio wakati unatubu inakuwa free. Inakuwa more free. So hiyo freedom ikiingia, sasa ndio unakuwa huru. Uhuru haiji tusipoungama. Tusipoungama uhuru haiji. Tutakuwa tukisema tu, najua niliwahi fanya hivi, kafanya hivi. Unajihukumu, unakaa mahali unalia. Like there's a story of a lady I know. She got married to a man, but she never disclosed the things she underwent when she was young. So one day, when they are already in life, they had a first child. Then when they were expecting the second child, there were complications. Then the doctor revealed that these complications are as a result of an abortion that happened earlier in life. But the lady never told the husband. It caused ripples in the family. Yeah, it caused ripples. But now, when this lady came to know the Lord, it was just that she should confess these things so that they walk away. Because anytime she will think, ya kwamba niliwahi kutoa mimba, akikaa mahali angelia, na mtu angejua analia gani. Angekaa tu mahali aseme, nilifanya hivi, kafanya hivi. It lingers in the mind. In fact, what you have done, you can never forget. It is never erased. So I'm here to tell us that in this life that we lead, there are no secrets. There are no secrets. The things that have been revealed, those are ours. The things that are not yet revealed, we go on our knees for the Lord to reveal them. We just go on our knees and the Lord shall reveal them. The Bible says somewhere in John, somewhere, the Bible says that the Holy Spirit reminds us. He reminds us of the things that we should repent. He brings it into our remembrance. He pulls it when it is time, so that you gather the freedom that you want to get. Bwana asifiwe sana. Yeah, so I want to give us time to reflect back and to the things that don't please God that you ever did. The things that you have never talked about to anybody, and you say, this, if so and so knows, or if anybody knows, can be very, very sorry for my life. Then you bring those things. Tell God, this, forgive me. The things that makes us stagnate, remaining a status quo for a very long time, are because of the past. The things that we hook into our lives and allow them to stay there longer. Our pastor think it is years ago, maybe some 2 or 3 years, he preached about giving your heart wholly to the Lord. And then he gave an illustration about somebody aliiba kuku na ikawa kila mara anakumbushwa, unakumbuka ile kuku, nakumbuka alisha tu. You remember the story? Unakumbuka ile kuku? Nakumbuka alisha tu, alisha samehewa. Sema hii nilisha samehewa. Ikiwa kuna kitu umesamehewa, hiyo usikuje kwayo. Lakini there is something that ile umeficha, ile hata huyo ajui. That is the one that I'm talking about. You bring it to God. The Bible says that our God is a God who never keeps a record of our sins. He never keeps a record. If he were to keep zile nimefanya zote, then I'm not heaven bound, but I'm hell bound. But because he forgives, kwa sababu Mungu haweki yale ya kale, then inaweza simama mbele ya watu na niseme I'm forgiven. Ah, the Lord already forgave me, so I'm free. At our place of work, whenever we work, people have grudges. I always tell people, if you have a grudge with me, utajisumbua, because me, we cross today, tomorrow I want to greet you, party a high five. We're going to learn a life. That is me. Mi sipendi ati ile kitu tulikosana jana utaka kuniambia leo. Kwambie hiyo kulingana na maandiko, hiyo nilishaweka kando, hiyo haiko. Wewe ndio unaiona, mimi nishaambia Mungu anisamehe. That's what the Bible says. Jua isianguke kama bado ungali na uchungu ndani. That's what the Bible says. So imagine, mtu amekushikia, akikuona kila siku, anakufiolea. Yani anafanya, like that every day. Na unaishi na watu, na una pollute nao kila siku. Na hapo ndio una spend most of your time. In fact, where you work is where you should enjoy more. Mahali unafanya kazi, that is where you should enjoy more. Why? That is where you spend most of the hours awake. Kwa nyumba, unakuwaga hapo 2 hours, the rest of the hours you are dead. You are not alive, you are not conscious. Umelala. Yeah, kama unaweza kaa kwa nyumba yako 4 hours a week, then kama tu una kitu unafanya, very important. The rest of the hours you are asleep. Ukiamka hivi tu 1 hour unatoka hivi. Most of the time una spend huko. Well, to some, nyumbani ndio unaspend sana. Lakini watu wengi, wale wanaingia kazini kwako, if you can't enjoy life there. So that is why this is to some ladies. Remembering the past too much and bringing it into the present. Wakati mmekosana, hata siku ile ingine ulifanya hivi, hata siku hiyo ingine ukafanya hivi. In fact, there is a time when I crisscrossed with my manager. She's a lady. Wakati tulikosana kuhusu kitu ambayo nimefanya sasa hiyo kosa, kajaribu kuleta zile za zamani kukiwa kwa kesi, kamwambia you are not doing right. Hizo si tulishaongea tukamaliza, mbona naleta sasa hii? Hizo uwezi kusema sasa hii. Hizo but I add anyway kwa hii discipline ambayo nataka kunipatia saa hii. Talk about this and this only. If you don't talk about that, we won't agree. Kaona kama akaniambia you are very rude, nikamwambia I'm not rude, I'm just factual. Vitu za zamani huwezi niletea wakati tunaongea. You talk about now. Au utapiga mtoto kwa sababu ya kosa ya zamani? Si utamuua basi. utamuua. Siku lingine ulifanya hivi. Ndio umezoea kufanya hivi. Umezoea kufanya hivi. You will kill the child. The child you just punish because of the current mistake. If not, watu wengine wataua watoto. Taua. So this is it even in normal life, in this life that we lead. The things that you undergo, they are the things of the present. Yeah. And if at all there is a way that we can pray to God to unleash those things of the past, it's only telling them to God to erase them. That's it. And when you have told it to God, believe that He has forgiven you, and it will be so. If you don't believe, that's another mistake. Si mtu anaweza kuomba, aone kama inaonekana Mungu hajanisamehe hata kama nimeomba. In fact, hiyo saa hata ndio mbaya sana. What does the Bible say about that? Unakuwa worse. Yeah, so unajimaliza. You'll never walk out of it. When you don't believe in the Lord that you pray to, regarding an issue that was, and now you want to delete it, and you disbelieve it, you disbelieve that the Lord has forgiven you, you are causing more harm to your human nature. Then, in that manner, faith will have no meaning to you. Faith will have no meaning. Because our meaning, so there is no faith in you, and faith there is no meaning to you. Let us all rise and all this. We thank God for this day. We bless the Lord's name. He is a good God. I want to give us time to go before the Lord. As you go before the Lord, ask God if there is anything that is hanging on to your life, that is causing you not to move steps ahead, that we may see you where you belong. Yeah, ask God to erase them, to erase them. Lord, erase them. Let that be your prayer. Lord, erase them. Nionapo amani kama shwari au niona kushida wa hali zote
Oh, Castle Monos, Malose Menete, Rebeco, Lomone Basso, Baloso monote redeso mokoso monose dekete. Ale makaso mokono monose dekeso monose. Oh, thank you, Jesus. We welcome you here in a mighty way. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Ole makaso monose dekete remeno mose. Oh, yale umetenda mama. Jote nima. Maana waya tinda.
A season of silence.
In
Swahili, you can translate that.